see that you're awake. Please, please don't be distressed. I'm here to help you. I need you to calm down and just take a few breaths. Breathe in. That's very good. Don't you feel just that little bit more relaxed now? Yes, I thought that stroking your face might make you feel a little bit better. Now, you're probably wondering where you are and what's happening. Yes, I admit that this is probably feeling quite strange and you're probably quite disorientated. But don't worry, I am here to help you. Who am I? Well, I don't so much as have a name, but I'm more or less your spiritual guide. Or you could call me your guardian angel. You can say both, and both are quite accurate. I am here. I was sent to help you on your journey because you are just now starting a new part of the journey that is life. In life, as a human, you go through different stages of existence. The first stage being birth. You spend 9 months inside of your mother, growing with her. And then you come to the time when your body leaves your mother's body and you become a whole person all to yourself and you start your journey on Earth. But in life, there are different parts to that one journey, and the part of the journey that you are on now is, granted, a very stressful one. And as your spiritual guide, I am under the obligation of telling you that your physical body has ceased to work. You are now spirit who is detached from your physical body. Yes, dear. Yes, you died. You don't remember, do you? No. Okay. That's very common for a spirit to block the person's moment of death from their memory. It's very common. Don't worry, the memories will come back. over time, as you, as time goes on, you will start remembering little pieces here and there, little bits of your past will start coming back to you. Even parts of your life. I know that it's a lot to take in, hearing that you died. But on the other hand, see it like this. Death is only the beginning. It is only one part of your life journey, of your existential journey.
I've been waiting a very long time for this day when we would actually meet face to face.
I have been watching you your entire life. I know all of your little secrets. I have witnessed all of your little indiscretions. Yes, I have seen everything. Watching you from the moment you were born to the moment that you died. Now I know you've probably got a lot of questions. You're probably wondering how you died. Now that is not my role as your spiritual guide to tell you how you died, because that would just confuse you so much more. I am here just to take your hands and guide you on your journey through your afterlife. To start, I have to help you relax, help you get into a state of mind where you are relaxed enough to start this next part of your journey. So I'm going to get my candle out again. You didn't see that part because you were not fully aware yet, but now you will see. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to light the candle. And I'm going to ask you to look deep into the flame and just concentrate on it, and I am going to help you find peace so we can start your journey. So listen to my voice while staring deep, deep into the flame. That's it, just look at the flame. Listen to my voice. You are undertaking a very, very important part of your life existence journey. You are about to discover certain parts of your soul that you did not know existed. You are going to enter into rooms that a part of your being that again you did not know existed. We're going to journey back into your life, and we are going to visualize the events that marked your existence. Just keep staring into the flame. Follow flame as I move it. And I would like you to sink deep into the depth of the flame. Let the flame consume you like it consumes the wick of this candle. We are going to now journey back to certain key points your life, and you will revisit them with the help of this flame. You are sinking deeper and deeper into your consciousness and unconsciousness. You can see back to your first childhood memory. You remember the first time you walked your first step. First words, the first day you went to school, the first person you kissed. Your partner and your children. And you remember all the good things that happened to you. Into the flame. The flame will guide you on your journey, just like I am doing. But the flame will help you concentrate and help you find the answers that you your soul is looking for. Hopefully, this flame will help you recover some memories which have gotten lost a little bit when your body was dying, and it's different for each person. Each soul reacts differently to the process of passing over to the next life. Think that you are relaxed enough to continue this process without the help of the candle, so I'm going to blow it out. Even spirits can appreciate smell of a candle blowing out. Smells good, doesn't it? Now that you understand a little bit better what's going on, I think that you've got a little your memories that are coming back little by little. Am I correct? Yes. The acceptation process has started, and let me just tell you that this is a really good sign. So the next step is for me to help explain and help you make your decisions on how you wish your karmic cycle to pursue itself. So basically, when a person passes over to the next side, when they die, their soul comes here. And they have to choose how they want to continue their journey.
There's more than one path
that is possible. Some spirits decide that they would like to go back to Earth, be reincarnated, and continue their karmic cycle that way by living another life and continuing on Earth in the form that they choose. And some people decide to become spiritual guides, just like me. Yes, spiritual guides or guardian angels. So if you want to, you can either reincarnate into another body, or you could choose to become like me, a guardian angel and or spiritual guide. It's two words for the same thing. And so if you decide to become, yes, you want to know more, okay. Well, basically, spiritual guides, like myself, are entities. We are not human. We are entities, is the best word for it, who are given by our superiors. We have superiors. I think everyone has superiors. And our superiors, they give us charges. People who are down on earth, living out whichever stage of their karmic circle that they're in, and we watch down on them. We try and influence them as best as we can. We help them make the right decisions, and some people decide to listen to us. We have our own special ways of getting our messages across to our charges, and we just watch them from the moment they're born to the moment they die, and then when they die, they come to us. And we do exactly what I'm doing for you. We help them on their journey. So as a guardian angel, we help people, our charges, in their everyday life, from childhood to old age. And then once they die, we help them transition into the other side and help them make their decisions as to how they want their karmic cycle to pursue. Let's say that some people made some really bad choices. They didn't listen to their spiritual guides in their life, or didn't know how to hear the messages that their spiritual guides were trying to get through to them. And maybe they lived a bad life. Maybe that person would decide that it would be better for them to become guardian angels to try and make up for the things that they regret in their life. And if they'd led bad lives and decided to reincarnate, they would probably have a really, really tough time in their next lives, because karma, it just, for those people, it would be better. It is better for them to become spiritual guides and be better than what they were in their previous lives. And as spiritual guides, usually, we stay spiritual guides for a very long time. But we can decide that enough's enough at some point or another, and if we've done our jobs well, we are allowed to be reincarnated into a body, into a whole new person, a whole new life to live. Although we won't have the conscious memories of our previous lives or of our lives as spiritual guides, our unconscious minds have all this information locked away deep down, and somehow it just helps guide us in our lives that we have chosen to relive in reincarnation. So now that you understand a little bit more about the karmic cycle and reincarnation and guardian angels, spiritual guides, I have to help you make a decision. Now, you can take your time thinking about it. Obviously, we do not expect spirits who have just undertaken started to undertake their secondary journeys straight away. You can decide that you want to stay a spirit for a little bit. Maybe look down on some of your friends and family that you had, the people in your life that cared for you and that you cared for also. So you don't need to make a decision straight away, but eventually you will have to decide. Do you, at the moment, have any idea of which way you would like to go? Okay. Yes, it's totally fine for you to be unsure at this point. That's normal. Maybe your soul isn't relaxed enough to make a decision yet. So I'm going to help you relax a little bit more. This heavenly makeup brush, which I am going to help you relax a little bit more. Yes, I completely understand that passing over to the other side is obviously very confusing and stressful, so you're going to be needing a little extra time and help relaxing. This is normal. Please don't feel like you have to rush. This is not a decision that you must take lightly. You must think about it thoroughly, because it is, after all, a decision that will change your life. So, I'm just going to take this makeup brush and I'm going to brush your face. And while I'm doing that, we can talk. And tell me if you have any memories that come back to you. If you've got any questions, you can ask me. Yes, I did say that we can be guardian angels as long as we want. Yes, I did say that. Yes, that does mean that us guardian angels live a long time. But, you know, time is different here. You will see after a while that time moves very differently. To know how long I've been doing this. Well, as I said, time moves very differently where we are compared to Earth. But I will say that I have been watching you your entire life. And throughout that process, I have looked exactly the way I look now. So you can imagine that I've done this before with countless other souls. You are not my only charge. I've got others, and in the past I have had others as well. So I don't know exactly how long it's been, because time, as I said, moves differently here. But also, we don't use the same system as humans. But, so you understand a little better. I have had countless charges before you, and I will have countless charges after you, which means I have been doing this for several lifetimes. And believe me, some people live a really long time. Some people live to quite old ages. And when they get to me, they are quite old. I see what you mean. Basically, you're asking whether I used to be human, and if I chose to become a guardian angel, and if so, did I die with this appearance, and just did I die young, basically? So, the answer is yes, I used to be human. And yes, I died young. It's not really my job as your guardian angel to talk about me and my lives that I've had, but I can see that it's helping you be less stressed out and accept the journey that you have to take a little bit more, because I can that knowing how it happened for me is helping you accept your journey. So basically, I lived in the times of the pharaohs. I was the daughter of a priestess. My family was quite wealthy. But my body succumbed to some illness. I couldn't tell you what illness it was because it was a really long time ago, and my memory is a little bit fuzzy because, as you can tell, I died at quite a young age, and I came to my spiritual guide quite young. So I decided to become a guardian angel so I could help other people. could guide them in their journeys. It's just, my guardian angel explained it all really well to me, and I just decided that that was for me, helping others. So yeah, I lived a really long time ago, and I died a really long time ago, thousands of years. So that answers your question. I've had lots and lots and lots of charges who I have guided throughout their lives, and who I've guided in death. It's really fulfilling. It feels really good to help people into that part, that next part of their existence. It feels amazing. I am so thankful, and I feel so lucky to have this opportunity. I don't know if one day I'm going to maybe reincarnate. Maybe. I think it might be good for me at some point in my spiritual journey to get reacquainted with the physical pleasures of life. Even just the pleasure of smelling earthly foods and the smell of freshly cut lawn, the smell of the Sahara. I miss the smell of the Sahara. So maybe one day, when I feel like I've got nothing left to give to any of my charges, maybe I will ask to be reincarnated, but until then, I am perfectly happy to help people like you into their own spiritual journey. I know that it's pretty scary, the idea of knowing that there is someone out there has been watching you for your entire life, and who knows all of your deepest, darkest secrets. Yes, dear. What question is that? Yes, I did say that we guardian angels have a view on the whole of our charges' lives. Yes, that does mean that I saw that, fling. Yeah. Yes, it also means that I saw you eat those things. Yes. Yes, and it does mean I know all of your deepest and darkest secrets. Yes, it does. I know everything about you. Everything that there is to know. I know about you, and yeah, I guess that is kind of scary, but you've got to know that there is no judgment. We don't judge people, we are here to guide them. Yes? Yeah, that's totally possible. So yeah, once you arrive in this stage of your journey, before taking any decisions, you can, of course, as I did actually mention it before, you can, of course, ask to have a look and be shown the people you left behind. Yeah, that's totally, yeah. But you have to realize that this is a short time after your passing, so those those people are still grieving. So if you want to see them now, I can show you. That's not a problem. But just bear in mind that they're going to be sad right now. And they are. I've had a look myself. They are very sad. But I must assure you that the people you left behind are taken care of. They are loved and they are sticking together. And they are helping each other to just get over the loss of you. But that being said, yes, I can show you. I can open a window to you, that world where they're still in it and you're not, and you can choose to watch for however long you decide, and whichever person you decide to. If there is a particular person that you want to look over, you can. Okay, I'll make that happen for you. So, what I want you to do is just close your eyes and listen to my voice. Okay. Now I'm going to touch your forehead. And I'm going to put the images of the people that you love into your mind. Concentrate. You have to do is visualize in your mind the person or the people that you want to see, and your mind will make them real in the window that I have just opened in between my hands. So go ahead. See? Yes, they're very sad. Losing you was very emotional for them. But you'll see, as time goes on, that they will get over losing you. That sounds a bit weird, granted. They'll never fully forget you, of course. When we leave the world that we were in, we're never completely forgotten until the people that we knew and their children and their children's children, until all of them are gone. Until then, we are never fully forgotten. Aww. I know, it's very emotional. I think that these views into the world that you just left, I think those visits should be quite short. So now I'm going to close this window. Future. visit the people that you love. It's there. I've given you the power. All you have to do is open your mind. Visually open that window that I just opened, and you will be able to revisit any person that you left behind. If there are any scenes, any events in your life that you would like to revisit, you can. That's not a problem. Once you master it, because it can be a little bit tricky, but you'll see that eventually you will master that ability. And you will be able to go back and see your family and friends whenever you want. But as I said, it's a good idea to keep the visits short, especially in the beginning, now, because you only just passed over to the other side. And visiting those people for too long might be too emotionally difficult your soul to enable you to continue on your journey and make the decisions that you have to make to continue on that journey. So I would advise not doing that too often and for not too long. But other than that, feel free. So right now, my time with you has come to end. I am no longer your spiritual guide. Of course, I'm always around up here somewhere, hanging out on a cloud or two. So if you have any questions, you can always come and see me, and I can still guide you, because I still love helping people, and I watched over you your entire life. I watched you being born and I watched you die. So it's emotional for me too. Even guardian angels are emotional sometimes. So feel free to come and see me whenever you want. But my job as your guardian angel is over, because you are now going to have to figure out on your own what you want to do next, whether you want to be reincarnated, whether you want to become like me, a spiritual guide. That is your decision to make, and I have tried to help you the best I can in explaining things and just helping you understand things a little bit better. But now I've done that, my job is done. You are now ready to go and explore paradise and make those existence decisions on your own. So I'm going to bid you a very good journey, and maybe I'll see you around sometime. I wish you well on your journey. Also down in the description. If you'd like to go and add me on there, I accept all invitations, because it's an account that is specifically just and only for this channel and nothing else. There's no personal information on it or anything. Sometimes I post pictures of during and after filming. I sometimes post bloopers on there, and also like personal thoughts about being an ASMR YouTuber, and I forgot what I was gonna say. Say thank you again for watching. Thank you for all the support.